Braking action. You would have heard this term as an air traffic controller. I'm also an air traffic controller who uses this term often. But sometimes it makes me confused. What does it mean when the braking action is good or poor? All I can do is simply give the information to the pilot. Have you thought about this? I hope that this video will help you to simply this matter. Which one is more dangerous, driving on a wet road or driving on a dry road? Of course, it's driving on a wet road due to the risk of hydroplaning. When driving on a wet road at a high speed, a water film is formed between the tire and the surface of the road, which interferes with braking force. Wet surface conditions are even more dangerous for aircrafts that use the runway with limited length. Braking action is a description of how easily an aircraft can stop on a runway. The braking action is determined in three ways. First, the airport operator determines the braking action by measuring factors that affect runway conditions, such as water, snow, and ice. They measure braking action not only by measuring the depth of the factors, but also by considering the outside temperature. Second, the operator of the airport measures the runway friction force using a special vehicle. Third, braking action can be obtained through the pilot's report. Braking action obtained in these ways is expressed by the terms good, good to medium, medium, medium to poor, poor, nil. The controllers and pilots use these terms to exchange information on braking action. ICAO and FAA describe in detail what these terms mean. Let's take a quick look. If the braking action is not good, this information must be given to the pilot. You can easily find out the accidents related to the braking action. In December 16, 2018, Southwest Flight 278 skidded off and left the runway while landing at the Burbank Airport and barely stopped at the over-runway area. In the morning of January 17, 2020, Delta Flight 1114 slipped and left onto the taxiway at the Kansas Airport, where it was wrecked by a storm. The accident forced Kansas City Airport to close for a while. What should air traffic controllers do to prevent these incidents related to braking action? 1. Remember that the braking action affects separation. Take a look at this traffic situation. The braking action is poor. One aircraft has just landed. Another aircraft was approaching 6 miles on final. The tower controller expected that the landed aircraft would clear the runway quickly via intersection taxiway Charlie. Thus, the controller instructed the departing aircraft to line up and wait on the runway. However, due to the bad braking condition, the aircraft that was landing roll vacated via the end of the runway. Eventually, the aircraft at the final was going around. After landing, most aircraft choose intersection or high-speed taxiways to clear the runway. But what about aircrafts that land on wet or icy runways? They will focus on slowing down their speed and trying to use the full length of the runway rather than using the intersection taxiway to vacate the runway quickly. Also, controllers should not instruct the pilot to clear the runway quickly or vacate via intersection taxiway. Just wait long enough for the pilot to slow down. 2. Consider the length of the runway. Do you have more than one runway at your airport and the length of them is not different? In such cases, assign a runway with better braking action to the aircraft as long as the traffic conditions permit. If the two runways have the same braking action and it's less than good, assign a longer runway. 3. Provide timely information. The latest information on braking action must be provided to all taking off and landing aircrafts in sufficient time. For aircrafts to take off, they at least must be provided while taxiing, and for landing aircrafts before the final descent. If the braking action is changed, the pilot must be notified immediately. 4. Express accurately. How do pilots and controllers exchange information about braking actions? The easiest way is to simply give information including the runway, runway conditions, and braking action. Runway 20, braking action poor, ice on runway. If the information is obtained from an aircraft, include the aircraft time and time of the information received. Braking action medium, reported by Boeing 737 at 0600 Zulu. Since the landing distance becomes longer for larger aircraft, when possible, include reports from super or heavy aircrafts when the arriving or departing aircraft is a super or heavy. If the braking action report affects only a portion of a runway, terms describing the location may be used. If the braking action gets worse towards the end of the runway, controllers should notify the pilot this information. During takeoff and landing, the pilot's action varies depending on the aircraft's position and speed, so this partial braking action information will be very helpful to the pilot. 5. Use ATIS. If the braking action is not good, include that information on ATIS. Braking action advisories are in effect. If your airport's ATIS can accommodate more information, it's a good idea to broadcast a term indicating the braking action or more detailed information. If you receive new information, don't forget to update ATIS on this, especially if the braking action is getting worse. Braking action is essential for safe operation. This information changes in real time, and controllers need to be able to respond actively. Even if there are no officially reported braking action, controllers should actively inform pilots whenever weather conditions are expected to affect the braking condition. Controllers should also require pilots and aircraft operators to report on braking action and make efforts to share this information with relevant personnel. The controller uses the phraseology cleared for takeoff, cleared to land when permitting taking off and landing. The term clear does not simply mean that there is nothing on the runway. Controllers can use this term only after considering numerous factors in a short period of time. Keep in mind that the braking action is a very important factor you should never forget. Subscribe and like are very helpful in producing the next video. ATC for you.